fixing the direction of the motors, but we can achieve rotation by having different speeds for the left and right motors. Then we will not get in place rotation, but we may achieve curved paths by altering the ratio of speeds of the left and the right motor. Now we have seen that total of two motors are required, one for the left and the right motor, right drive each, and both are responsible for translation and rotational motion. We try to analyze some pros and cons of the differential drive. First, it is very simple and easy to use. It can be constructed very quickly without much design process. But there is one disadvantage of the differential drive, that it is very difficult to make it move in a straight line. As we know that nothing is ideal. So two motors manufactured in the same assembly line end up with different characteristics, as well as in a differential drive, each of the drives, left and right motor drive, may be experiencing a different friction, because the uniform the surface on which the robot is moving may not be uniform. So in that case, it is very difficult to move in a straight line. It will always have a tendency to bend towards some direction. perpendicular to its direction of freedom. That is, in this wheel is supposed to rotate in this direction, but it is actually moving perpendicular to this, and thus we are losing contact with the ground, and this difference is very difficult to detect and analyze. Thus we may end up at a different place than we were supposed to. Rest of its properties and calculation of dynamics is same as the differential drive system. Then there is another type of drive known as the articulated drive. In this, what we have, it is very close to the car type mechanism, but there is one basic difference, that the body of the robot is bifurcated into two halves with a hinge in between. The forward and backward motions are determined by the wheels, motion of the wheels, and the turning is determined by the angle that each half makes with the other and is controlled by a linear actuator. You see, we have seen that two actuators are needed, one for the drive wheels and one to change the pivot angle, that is the linear actuator. Now rest of the system is very working of the system is very similar to the car type mechanism, and hence this too is an example of non-holonomic system in which the both degrees of freedom that the robot has is related to each other in a complex fashion and may be difficult for the controller to properly guide it through some path. Then comes one of the most difficult systems to design, but the easiest among the drive systems to use, that is the synchronous drive. What is the synchronous drive? What we have in a synchronous drive is all the wheels are always parallel to each other. Now when turning, the wheels rotate a certain degree with respect to the orientation of the robot, and they continue to move in that the robot continues to move in the direction in which the wheels point. But one thing that has to be observed is that the orientation of the bot, that the body of the robot keeps looking at the same direction. It can move sideways or at any given heading, but it continues to look in the same direction as it has started. Now there are certain advantages by using the synchronous drive, that is the translation, that is forward and backward motion of the robot is controlled by a single set of motor and is independent of the turning, and the turning is solely controlled by the orientation of the wheel with respect to the wheel or wheels with respect to the robot body. And as all the wheels are parallel to each other, thus the orientation of the robot remains the same, but the robot starts moving in a different heading given by the direction of the wheel. This system is quite complex in designing, but usage of this system for a robot is very simple. There is not much of difficulty in designing a controller for such a system. Then comes one of the most unique drives of the locomotion system, that is the pivot drive. It is different from any other type of drive we have discussed so far. The wheels of a pivot drive provide for forward and backward motion, and when we want it to turn, what we do is lower a platform onto the ground where we can see, and by this we lift off the body of the robot above the ground and make it turn by rotating the body over this drive shaft, about this drive shaft, to a desired heading. And whenever when we have achieved perfectly straight line motion, as well as when it rotates, it can perform in place rotations. That is, it does not need any space to turn, it can turn on its own position. This system can guarantee perfect straight line motion as well as accurate in place turns. So, where very accurate odometry is required, we can use this system. There are some issues with the pivot drive. The system designing is not simple, it's quite complex. Still more complex eliminates the use of three motors. The wheels and the platform rotation are coupled to a single motor. When we are going for translation motion, the platform is above ground, so we don't have any problem with it rotating. And when we want to turn, the wheels are above ground, so both can be driven by a single motor, turn by turn. There is one disadvantage with this system, that it can take only in-place turns. If we need it to move in a certain curve, we may not be able to achieve it. So that is the end of the discussion of pivot drive. The next comes the dual differential drive. Dual differential drive aims at keeping the advantages of the differential drive over the other drive and trying to eliminate the disadvantages with or problems with the differential drive. The major problem with the differential drive is inability to make it move in a perfect straight line. So what we do is do a certain unique arrangement of gears to achieve this. When we are trying to move the bot in a straight line, the green colored gear, as you can see, is not in contact with any of the yellow or blue gears. Instead, these two gears are coupled together, and hence both have the same speed and it achieves straight line motion. When we wish to make this robot turn, we force this gear in between the yellow and the blue gears, and by forcing this, there develops a gap between these two gears, and this link gets delinked, and as this is introduced, the direction of rotation of the left and right wheels gets reversed and it is able to take in place rotation. That is all there to the locomotion system. Now I'll discuss in brief about the power supply system. For any mobile robot to function to its optimum potential, we need a suitable power supply. As we are saying that our robot is mobile,